Joining me now, Wyoming Senator John Barrasso, chair of the Senate Republican Conference. Senator Barrasso, welcome back, sir. Happy New Year. You know, you don't know whether to laugh or cry over some of this stuff. I don't know. I'll let you decide. You're smarter than I am. I want to go back. The Hillary stuff is just too wonderful. We're going to cover that in a political panel later on. But in all seriousness, I thought Biden's speech was a disaster yesterday. I'm glad Mitch McConnell slammed back. What's your take on this whole story? You got a legislative filibuster, and you've got this government takeover of election processes and overall in the states. How do you see this, Senator Barrasso?
And you see 7% inflation, the highest inflation in 40 years. That's what people are talking about in Wyoming and across the country. You see an open southern border. That's what people are talking about across the country. You see crime in the cities. You see COVID surging. Those are the things people are talking about in Wyoming and across the country. And what Joe Biden is talking about in Georgia yesterday is something that just shows up as an asterisk. It's not even in the top 20 of issues and concerns for the American people. Joe Biden apparently is coming to Capitol Hill tomorrow to twist arms for his so-called election bill, which gets rid of voter picture identification, which you think you ought to be able to prove who you are when you ask for a ballot. He's going to twist arms for that, but he's not coming with a plan for the economy, for inflation, not coming with a plan of getting kids back to school. That's what the American people are focused on. And to me, Joe Biden and these Democrats who think that this is the key issue, they must be living in the twilight zone with record inflation. You know, the house is on fire, the roof is falling in. They're not just tone deaf. They are derelict in their duties to the American people.
So Chuck Schumer, Senator Schumer says he's going to have a vote tomorrow. I read someplace Biden's going up to have a pep rally with the Democratic Senate conference. I read someplace. I don't know if this stuff is true. You can tell us. But is it, and this is just pointless. They're going to lose. And they're doing themselves great harm in the process. In other words, it's like defeat after defeat, Senator Barrasso. You know, the BBB bill's going down. This bill's going down. The filibuster thing's going down. We're in trouble with Russia inside the Ukraine. We've already botched the Afghanistan story. God knows what's going to happen with China and Taiwan. I'm just saying, why does Biden insist on going after these futile efforts and then alienating the whole country? I mean, let me do Quinnipiac again. 33%. This is among all adults, Senator Barrasso. Quinnipiac, which is a fairly liberal poll as a rule, 33% approve of Biden, 53% disapprove. Those are big numbers. 28-51 among Hispanics, 26-61 among men, 25-57 among Indies. I mean, those are dreadful numbers, but that's, you know, almost all the polls are showing that. Why don't they get this, Senator Barrasso? When will heads roll in the White House and directions change? Or maybe they won't.
Well, the American people get it. They understand that our president is overwhelmed with the activities today and ineffective at dealing with any of these major issues that are major issues in their life. And, you know, with these inflation numbers, people are having to change so much about the way they live, they shop, they drive, how they eat. These things are affecting people on a daily basis, and they are not happy about it. I don't know who's the one to pull the switch at the White House and say heads will roll, because it doesn't seem that Joe Biden is giving orders. It seems like he's taking orders from his staff, who must be calling the tune, and they are truly out of touch with what I think every member of the Senate must be hearing at home for those that go home. And those are the Republicans that go home every weekend, talk to their friends and their neighbors at home about what's happening in their communities and in their lives. And that's why I think Joe Biden's numbers are deservedly so low.
You know, Senator, you've got all these Democrats, quote, retiring from the House. Last count, I think, is 26. These are 26 incumbents. They're not going to run again, call it retirement or whatever, I think, because they're going to lose. In the Senate, just in recent days, your colleagues, John Thune and Ron Johnson, have said they will run again, which strikes me as a very good thing. I think both are odds on to win. So, Senator Barrasso, is the cavalry coming to rescue us in the midterms?
Oh, the cavalry's coming, the cavalry of the American voters, and they know what's so important for the country. We need to take back the House, take back the Senate, and make Joe Biden effectively a one-half term president. Mm. And why we're fighting so hard so they don't change the rules is we want to make sure that by the time the cavalry gets here with the election, the people in the wagon train have survived. But if the Biden administration is able to push forward at 50-50 Senate, which is what they're trying to do by getting rid of the filibuster, their radical, extreme, dangerous, scary agenda, it's going to be hard to reverse that. And that's the fight we're in. And that's why we're fighting so hard. And you saw Mitch on the floor today to prevent the Democrats from doing what Schumer and Biden and others want to do now, but in the past have said they were against doing it because the Senate is supposed to be a place, certainly with a 50-50 Senate, where we come together for solutions, look for areas where we can cooperate, find common ground. That's not what the Democrats want to do. They want this freight train to socialism.
Sam Brasso, two things left quickly. Number one, it looks to me like the big government socialist bill is, in fact, dead. Save America, kill the bill. Senator Schumer keeps saying they're going to have a vote. Vote on what? Isn't it dead?
Well, I sure hope it is. I think Chuck Grassley yesterday on this show said it was on life support.
Yeah.
When you take a look at these inflation numbers at a 40-year high, anybody who thinks that putting $5 trillion additional federal dollars into this economy is going to help. It's going to really pour fuel on the flames of inflation. We cannot let that happen.
Why is he going to vote on it? Why doesn't he just give it up? Why does he just wave the flag of surrender? Why don't they try to do business? And never mind. I don't want them to do business. The whole bill's terrible. I take it back. I withdraw the question. I don't even want to go down that road. Last one, Sam Brasso. Ted Cruz's bill or amendment to restore the Nord Stream 2 sanctions on Russia. Seems to me, in the midst of this Ukraine blow-up, that's the least we can do. And we never should have given Putin that little golden gift in the first place. Now, number one, what's the outcome of that vote going to be if you get the vote? And number two, why is the White House opposing it? They're talking sanctions. Here's Cruz, I mean, really trying to help them and defend American interests. So what's your outlook on this vote?
We're going to have the vote. I'm, of course, a co-sponsor, support this all the way. We need to stop this Russian pipeline of Russian energy from Russia to Germany. Look, we know Vladimir Putin uses energy as a geopolitical weapon. And it's his energy money right now, which is the cash cow, that is allowing for all this aggression against Ukraine. Those are the problems. And I think that Vladimir Putin looks at Joe Biden and sees somebody as weak and indecisive, because it's Biden who killed the U.S. energy Keystone pipeline, but he's allowed the Russian Nord Stream 2 pipeline. Putin is cunning, opportunistic, aggressive. He has Ukraine almost surrounded now with his troops. And I think that Putin only respects strength, not statements. And a show of strength would be to block this pipeline. That's actually action, not just words.
Yeah, action. No time like the present. Let's just lay down a marker here, finally. Last one, I forgot I had one more. I woke up at 5 o'clock this morning in Des Moines, Iowa, but I got here for the show. I'm pushing hard for a future agenda. I know it's not going to pass, but I think Republicans in both houses should push to make the Trump tax cuts permanent. And Sam Brasso, I want to read you my pal Scott Rasmussen, who's an ace pollster, a very good pollster. He said 57, he's polled this for me, 57% favor making the Trump tax cuts permanent. Only 24% are opposed. So it's more than 2-1. Can we put that on the agenda, put on the offensive? We elect Republicans are going to make the highly successful Trump tax cuts permanent.
You're right. They were very highly successful, continue to be successful. I want to make them permanent. I also want to complete the wall. I want American energy independence. I have a whole list of things that are important, and that's in the top of the list, Larry.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate it very much, Senator John Brasso. Thanks for coming back. See you soon. All right, folks.